students, so today we will discuss about the ribosomes and cytoskeleton. Ribosomes are the non-membrane bounded cell organelles, means not surrounded by any membrane, and they are granular structure, means they appear like grains or any particles like substance. They are found in the cytoplasm of the prokaryotes and as well as the eukaryote cell, and hence ribosomes are called as a non-membrane granular structures and mainly made up of the RNA, that is ribonucleic acid, and the proteins. Complete the ribosomes will be made up of the RNA and proteins. So it was first by a person called George Faraday observed the ribosomes in 1953. So ribosomes generally it is made up of two units, and one will be the larger unit and another will be the smaller unit. And based on the type of the cell, whether in eukaryotic cell or whether in prokaryotic cell, the ribosomes are of two types. In case of the prokaryotic cell, the ribosomes is of 70S ribosomes. In eukaryotic cell, the ribosome is of 80S type of ribosome. In prokaryotic 70S, we have already discussed, it will be having a larger unit and smaller unit. The larger unit, it is of 50S, and the smaller unit is of 30S. And in the same way, in the eukaryotic cell, the larger unit will be of, again here also larger and smaller unit, the larger it is of 60S and the smaller is of 40S. Together it is called 80S, in case of prokaryote together called as a 70S. So why it is called, that is 50, 30 means 80, but we have written here it as 70S. The same way here 60 plus 40 it should be 100, but we have written 80S. So why it is so? For that we should know what is S. First let us know what is S. S means it is an Swedberg unit, because this was first discovered, that is in Swedberg. He was the person first he found the unit, and hence it is called as a Swedberg unit. That S stands for the, means Swedberg unit means it stands for the sedimentation coefficient means based on the sedimentation coefficient, based on how it is going to sediment, based on that it is indirectly trying to measure the density and size. Directly the size and density it cannot be measured. So based on that sedimentation, how it is going to sediment, based on that the density and the size of the particle is being measured. Here the ribosome density and size it is tried to measure based on the sedimentation coefficient, and then that hence it is called as an S, that is the Swedberg unit, the unit one which measures the sedimentation coefficient and try to measure the, indirectly measure the density and size, is called as a Swedberg unit. Okay, so how this sedimentation coefficient indirectly measure the density and size means, for example, if we take any liquid suspension in which the particles are suspended. So you have taken a liquid and the particles are suspended. If you want to separate that liquid and the particles, you have to allow the liquid to stand without any disturbance for few minutes or few hours. After few hours, you can observe that the particles generally which are heavier, it is going to settle, and the water or the liquid which is the lighter, it will stand above. The heavier particles, it is going to settle, which is called as a sedimentation. This is in general, if the particle size are bigger, if you allow the suspension to stand, automatically it is going to separate after a few hours. But what will we do if the particle size are smaller, very small? In that case, even if you allow the suspension to stand, it is very difficult to settle because the particle size will be very small. So in case of the cell suspension, if you take a cell suspension, so the ribosomes, endoplasmic reticulum, and these are very smaller, which measures in nanometer and angstrom unit, micrometer, measured in very, because of it, they are very smaller. So in that case, those particles or the cellular components is not going to settle. So in that case, we can use the technique that is called centrifugation. So here you can see a centrifuge, okay? So in which that centrifuge machine, centrifugation can be done. So what is centrifugation? How will you do means, in case of the cell suspension, you have taken a suspension of the cell and that it is difficult to sediment. So we can take that cell suspension and keep in the centrifuge. And then you have to rotate that centrifuge in a very high speed. So when you rotate that centrifuge in a very high speed, what happens? The smaller particles will sediment, is going to separate, and it is going to sediment. And that technique we call it as an centrifugation. And this is used to separate the cellular components. So in the same way, the ribosomes, when they are allowed for in the centrifugation technique, it undergoes sedimentation. So when the sedimentation occurred, the larger unit the sedimentation had occurred, and then the density and size was tried to measure, and the density and size it was about 50. And based on the sedimentation coefficient, here the density of the smaller unit was 30. Okay, based on the sedimentation, the density of the larger unit was 50. And based on the sedimentation, the density of the smaller unit was 30. When the complete ribosomes was sedimented, based on the sedimentation coefficient, the density of the complete ribosomes, it was about 70. So because of that only, that is the larger unit 50, smaller unit 30, together not 80, together based on the sedimentation coefficient, the density was about 70, yes. And hence in the prokaryotes, the ribosomes is of 70, yes, type. In the same way, when the eukaryote ribosomes, the larger unit it was sedimented, means it was centrifugation was done, and based on the sedimentation, the density was about 60, the larger unit, and the density was 60, yes, and the smaller unit density based on the sedimentation coefficient was 40, and together it was 80. So together the density was 80, and density is called as an 80, yes. So in this way, the ribosomes in the prokaryotes, it is of 70S. In the eukaryotes, it is of 80S. And here in eukaryotes, in the cytoplasm, you can find the 80S ribosomes. But whereas in the eukaryotes, the mitochondria and the chloroplast, in these cell organelles, you can observe the ribosomes, which is of 70S type. So in this way, this is about the discovery and the structure and the types of the ribosomes. And coming to the functions of the ribosomes, ribosomes are mainly involved in the synthesis of what? Protein. So main function of the ribosomes is to synthesize the protein in the cell, and hence it is called as an protein factories. So protein factories of the cell, ribosomes is considered as an protein factories of the cell. So how it will synthesize the protein, all that you will be studying in detail in your second year PUC. So how in detail process there it is being described. So hence the ribosomes are called as an protein factories of the cell, and this is about the ribosomes. Next, coming to the cytoskeleton. as the name itself suggests, cyto means cell skeleton. That is the one which acts like the skeleton to the cell. That is called as a cytoskeleton. So which are the cytoskeleton in the cell? That is nothing but there are many filamentous protein fibers are present inside the cell. Here you can see the cell which is showing the detailed structure. There are many filament-like protein fibers which are present. There are many protein fibers are present. For example, intermediate filament, microtubules or actin filaments, all these are an filament-like protein fibers. Okay, example, intermediate filaments, microtubule and the actin filament. These are the different types of filament-like protein fibers and all are present in the cytoplasm of the cell. And what happens? All these are arranged in such a way inside the cell, it forms a network. Which type of network? Complex network. Such complex network-like structure, which is made up of filament-like protein fibers inside the cytoplasm, that is called as cytoskeleton. All these protein fibers give the support to the cell. All it gives the support to the cell and hence act like the skeleton to the cell, and hence it is called as a cytoskeleton. And what are the major functions of the cytoskeleton? That is, it gives the mechanical support. Functions of cytoskeleton, it gives the mechanical support to the cell and also maintain the shape of the cell, and also helps in motility of the cell. So the cytoskeleton, it is in many different types of filament-like protein fibers all together forming a complex network-like structure is called as a cytoskeleton. What these protein filaments is going to do means it will give the mechanical support to the cell and maintain the shape of the cell and also helps in the motility movement of the cell. So these are the major functions of the cytoskeleton. So today we discussed about the ribosomes, the cytoskeleton. Ribosomes are the protein factory. Cytoskeleton is the one which gives the support to the cell, and hence it is called cytoskeleton. Thank you.